The story of Moses' birth is one of the most popular tales from the Bible. His birth underneath the oppression of Pharaoh and his deliverance into Egyptian royalty by being found in the basket on the Nile are widely known by Jews and Christians the world over. However, some skeptics have asserted that this story is fiction. Beyond that, they have claimed that this story is lifted directly from pagan mythology. There are two figures who are cited as potential sources for the story of Moses: the Egyptian god Horus and the Akkadian king Sargon. On the surface, both of these figures contain elements in the narratives of their lives that appear strikingly similar to what we find in the biblical account of Moses. Sargon of Akkad is remembered as one of the great rulers and conquerors of the ancient world. He is generally credited with building the first empire in recorded history. In other words, the first kingdom that had borders extended beyond its native lands. Its territory encompassed much of Mesopotamia and the Fertile Crescent, places that are featured frequently in the biblical narrative. Many subsequent rulers of the various nation-states of Mesopotamia sought to emulate Sargon's achievements and to claim him as part of their ancestry. In the wake of his life, Sargon's prestige gave way to many cultural myths and stories about his origins and rise to power. One of these tales, known as the Legend of Sargon, says that, as a baby, he was placed, quote, in a reed basket, waterproofed with bitumen, and set adrift in the Euphrates River. Subsequently, the basket was found by Akki, the gardener of the goddess Ishtar, who reared the baby. Given that Sargon's life was approximately 1,000 years earlier than that of Moses, it's easy to see why some have supposed that the Moses story derives from the legend of Sargon. However, upon closer examination, there are some problems with jumping to this conclusion. First and foremost, though Sargon's actual lifetime is much earlier than Moses, this apocryphal story about him is not. Quote, "The surviving fragments of the tale are Neo-Assyrian and Neo-Babylonian in date, or the 7th to 6th centuries BC. This means that this account is from roughly the same time period that encompassed the destruction of Israel by Assyria and Judah by Babylon, some 800 plus years after Moses' lifetime. It's impossible for the biblical authors to have plagiarized a story about Sargon if that story didn't even exist yet. Further, noted Egyptologist Donald Redford, upon examining all of the stories containing the, quote, exposed child motif from the ancient Near East, divided these stories into three broad narrative categories. 1. The child is exposed owing to shameful circumstances. 2. A king or powerful figure tries to kill the child because they are a threat to his rule. And 3. A massacre is introduced that threatens the life of the child as well as others. Redford notes that the legend of Sargon fits in the first category, because Sargon's birth in the story is considered scandalous, as his mother was supposed to have remained chaste. On the other hand, Moses' birth story fits into the third category, as his flight in the basket on the Nile is prompted by the oppression of Pharaoh on all the male Hebrew infants. Quote, "Placing the two tales in very different circumstances illustrates that, while there are some intriguing similarities between the two, there are fundamental differences." Hence, Redford concludes, quote, "They are not true parallels," unquote. Even if the legend of Sargon were older than the story of Moses, which it's not, the categorical differences between the two should caution people against citing one as a plagiarization of the other. As mentioned, though, there is possibly another candidate for an antecedent to the Moses story in the various accounts of the Egyptian god Horus. Like the story of Sargon, there are some surface-level similarities that Horus has with Moses, including an instance where the infant Horus is hidden by his mother, the goddess Isis, in a basket in the Nile Delta to protect him from his uncle, Seth, who killed his father, the god Osiris. Given that the Moses story, as well as the sojourn and oppression of the Israelites, is set in Egypt, some have supposed that the Horus myth was incorporated into the biblical narrative when the Exodus story was put into writing. Like the Sargon myth, The association of the Horus myth with the account of Moses also fails on chronological grounds. The surviving accounts of this myth date to the Greco-Roman period of Egyptian history, between 1200 and 1500 years after the time of Moses. These stories are so far into the future relative to Moses that they are nearly contemporary with the life of Jesus. Obviously, again, it's ridiculous to see Moses as a plagiarization of a story that would not exist for another 1,000+ years. Even though the accounts of Moses, Sargon, and Horus are not related to one another, why do they each share the motif of a baby in a basket set adrift in a river? In the words of Egyptologist James Hoffmeyer, quote, "The reason for the multitude of stories from across the Near East and Mediterranean of casting a child into the waters is that it may reflect the ancient practice of committing an unwanted child, or one needing protection, into the hands of Providence. A modern parallel would be leaving a baby on the steps of an orphanage or at the door of a church." For more information on Moses, the sojourn of the Israelites in Egypt, and the Exodus, please see my playlist titled Israel in Egypt and the Exodus. Also, I recommend Israel in Egypt by James Hoffmeyer. You will find a link to this book in the description.